Hey guys, Guy Level here, and we don't have time. You want your camera overlay to look like this. Can we even call it an overlay? It's not really an overlay. It's just a camera shape with a drop shadow or with a glow. Anyways, you've seen some big streamers are adopting this new style. You want to have it too. I'm gonna show you how to do it for free. Oh, this is my old chair. This is my new chair that I unboxed and assembled over at my tech channel. So go check it out. So step number one, go to photopea.com. I know it's pronounced photopea. I don't care. I like pronouncing it photopea. We're gonna assume that your main camera is at least 720p. Or 1080p, so it's gonna be a 16:9 aspect ratio. So here we're gonna click on new project. So basically you put 720p resolution here or 1080p. I'm gonna put 1080p, so that's 1920x1080. You could bump up the DPI, but we don't care. Create, boom, we have a white background. That was the default. What we can do is double click on this, double click on the layer, not on the name, click okay. I actually cannot, oh, I can unlock it. Just unlock the layer. I'm more used to Photoshop than Photopea, okay? Now you can press Control-I, I believe. Boom, now it's black. Okay, so the whole thing with mask is that black hides, white reveals. So we're gonna go find our rectangle tool somewhere. Nice, and we're gonna pick a corner radius. Let's say something about 50, press Enter, and place it towards the middle. Maybe 50 is not enough. Let me Control-Z. Let's say more like 80, okay? Now you can drag and drop the shape that you want. Just make sure that the height is max. Boom, something like that. You can double click here on the color here, or you can go to fill and then change the color to white. I'm gonna press Control-A in order to select everything. I'm gonna go to my move tool by clicking on the little mouse, and I'm going to center this, center horizontally, top here, center vertically, it doesn't really matter, but whatever. I'm gonna press Control-D. Okay, that deselects everything. And technically that's it. That's our that's our shape. But since we do want to have a drop shadow or some more things, let me Control-Alt-T, okay? So we're gonna make this actually a little smaller than our actual camera. And here we can really play with the shape, but let's make it slightly smaller just to give some space for the drop shadow or whatever we're gonna add. Okay, I'm gonna press Enter and I'm gonna duplicate it. I'm gonna hold Alt on my keyboard, drag this up, boom, I have a second shape. I'm gonna turn off that bottom shape. This is gonna be our mask. And what we're looking at right now is going to be the actual quote unquote camera overlay. All right, I'm gonna turn off the background just so we can see a little bit better. While this is selected, I'm gonna go down here and click on Effects. That's layer style basically. And we can click drop shadow. And you can pick the angle of your drop shadow. Usually like that, it's pretty cool. And the opacity, you can play around with it like a lot. So just click okay, and you're almost done. Now, while this is selected, you see this is opacity and this is fill. You wanna turn down fill. And what that does is basically turn off the actual layer, but you still have the drop shadow, okay? So now what you can do is export this. Export as PNG, click OK, and call it shadow. Boom, all right. And now we're gonna turn on the mask, turn this off, turn this on, and do the same thing. Now we're gonna save, export as PNG, click save, call it whatever you want. I'm gonna call this one mask. Boom, technically you have it. While you're here, if you want some variation, you can always just add them. Just go click, double click on the effects panel here. If you don't want a drop shadow or you just want a glow, just keep in mind that the glow will appear on top too. But if you want the drop shadow to have a different color, for example, you can go ahead and pick whatever color. You know your boy loves the purple. So we're gonna do a little bit of purple here. All right, boom, just in case. And I'm gonna export that one too. Save, boom, and I'm gonna call this one Shadow Purple. All right, now let's open up OBS. Okay, here I have an empty scene in OBS Studio. I'm gonna click plus in order to add a video capture device. I'm gonna make sure that's gonna be my main camera. Well, this is not my main camera. Hi, how you doing? This is my main camera, right there. Hey, look at that, look how I look. Now you're gonna right click on your camera, click filters, click plus under effect filters. Boom, we're gonna add an image mask blend, click okay, click browse, and go find whatever you just saved. All right, and this is where you're gonna upload the mask part. Click on this, click on that, and close. There you go, you have that kind of a webcam. Okay, let's add an image, okay, so plus image, click okay, name it whatever you want, I don't care. And then you can add the shadow, for example, but the shadow is not going to be visible here. So let me add the purple so at least we can see it. with the background. Ooh, and that's it. It's that simple. If you want to add like a an icon in here, you want to add a little icon in here and then have your most recent cheerer, most recent subscriber, or anything like that, it's absolutely possible. Just Google whatever icon you're looking for. For example, I have a cheer GIF here. Let me drop this here. Oh, would you look at that? Let me double click, make sure it's okay. It's a GIF, and it's animated, so I can, you know, just scale it up like that. And if I wanted to put my most recent cheerer, I can do that too. Let me go find a text, whatever, read from file, and I'm gonna go find my stream labels. If you're using Stream Elements, this is gonna be different, but I'm using Streamlabs, so yeah. Stream labels, and I'm gonna find my most recent cheerer. Most recent cheerer is right here. I can do this. I can pick a font if I want. Let's not pick a, we don't have time for this, okay? And let's do this, and this is the part where, well, I'm gonna make it a little smaller. And I can right click filters plus add a scroll, click OK, try to take a look at this, limit the width until it looks like it fits the whole thing. 1400 is too much, 1200 seems to be perfect. And now we can play with the horizontal speed, and I'm gonna make it go faster just for the sake of demonstration, but there you go, just like that. Okay, right now we have it in a separate scene, so you can add this scene as a source, but we can group this all up if we wanted to. Just hold shift, click on the bottom one, click on the top one, right click, group selected items, cam group, boom, and now you can add it to whatever you want. Okay, I can right click on the group, click copy, and I'm gonna put it in a game scene. Right click and then paste duplicate, for example. Boom, okay. What I can do is lower it like that, and I can place it wherever I want. Okay, if you want to crop the sides, you can hold alt, crop the sides, but there you go. And this is how you get like a very, very clean camera overlay. Is that easy? And that's pretty much it. That's how you can make this very, very clean looking camera overlay, if you want to call it that way. If you want some more complex or even animated camera overlays, you can go to gumroad.com/guide level. I have a bunch of them that are free, and then the rest is just straight up very affordable. I'm talking cents. Those images that I created will be available, link in the description. I'll probably upload them to Imgur or something like that. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Check out the links in the description, all of them. And in the meantime, YouTube is gonna show you what they think is the best video you should watch next. At the bottom of it, you will see my most recent video. Go check out my tech channel. This is where I uploaded the unboxing and assembly of this new chair, this $500 chair. And I will see you guys next time. Thank you again for watching. Go out there, make me proud. Get level out.